Okay, first create a text, press T, or you can click this icon and type, double click to select all, and change font to Shington. And you can click this icon, the transform tool, to enter the transform, because I want to scale it up. Click till you see this arrow and hold Ctrl Shift to scale it up proportionally. And placing on the middle of this canvas. You can buy the font in the link in the description. This is not a promotion, I don't get any endorsement from this font. I like this font because it gives me more retro looks. Next, I'm using glyphs to change the variation of this H letter. So let me show you what I mean. Press T to edit the text and click. And just select this H letter and open the character map. Right. Change the font to same font, Washington. And you can change the view to by Unicode block. And find the private use area. For example, I want to change the H letter to this. So just double click, click copy, Ctrl V to paste. And I want to change this A letter to this variation. And double click, click copy, Ctrl V to paste. So that's the glyphs on the font. You can change the variation of a character in that font. Or you can see my previous video, I'm using another font and using glyphs. Let me scale it down by holding Ctrl. Next, create a gradient, click the text, and click this gradient tool, or the shortcut is G. You can drag from the top to the bottom, then double click this top node, and press T, take the eyedropper tool, and change the color to this color. Or you can put this color code to here, and edit objects, or the shortcut is Shift-Ctrl-F. And for the bottom, just double click, change the color to this color. Okay, you can adjust the gradient and press F1 to release. Okay, next, let's create an outstroke. So, click the text and press Ctrl D to duplicate. And now you have the duplicated text. And change the color to this color, press D, and click this color. Increase the outstroke in path, choose the offset. And I'm using this shortcut for a few times, Ctrl and with close parentheses, and you can send it to the bottom. You can increase more with the shortcut on the keyboard, Ctrl with close parentheses. Let me scale it down the text again, and hold Ctrl Shift to scale proportionally on the center. Duplicate the stroke, press Ctrl D. And move. You see that's because this, you see this tooltip, because it's, you turn on this toggle snapping, let's turn it off, click this, and try to move freely. And send it to the bottom again. Or you can move with arrow on the keyboard to create a small increment movement. And the last, I'm going to add the shading. For the text, press B to activate the Bezier tool. Now we're using the Bezier tool, and I start to click from here to here, and just drag and hold Shift to lock the corner, and then release. Connect to the first node. Press D and change the color to this color. And you can remove the stroke on the left bottom corner. Right click, choose remove stroke. Okay. You still can adjust it by pressing F2, then click this shape. Just follow this shape of this A letter. I'm going to add again. Okay, hold shift to lock the corner. See like this. Then release. And connect to the first node. Press D and change the color to this color. And right click, choose remove stroke. and you can add more shape. That's it. I hope you learned something new, how to create a custom font on Inkscape. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.